I say the same thing twice, I'm awkward when I speak. Ain't got the perfect smile, don't turn heads on my street. Trying to be a superstar like everybody else.
Delirio, 1426, presents movie review number 6. Tour 1, 2, and 3. Delirio, 1, 4, 2, 3. Hey, guys, what's up? It's your boy, Delirio, 1, 4, 2, 6, a brand new smoking new haircut video. And the first vlog that I did, apart from like the Bachelor Cricket one, but that's more sport. I said maybe a video on Goal 1, 2, and 3. If you haven't seen it, I recommend you do a Conor Becker play Santiago Munoz. And there's boy Gavin Hart, don't forget who plays in the Elson News one. And then Goal 3, there's, I forget their names as well, but the boy called Charlie Braithwaite. And your man, Liam. We have second as well. I just can't forget names of them, man. Names! Alright, Goal 1 is about this. It's about this young Santiago Munoz dude who plays for the boy, gets known by a scout from Newcastle, and he gets the opportunity to go over if he gets enough money. And he gets up the money. His dad steals it to buy a new truck, but then his grandma's giving him the money to like go there to get a scout. He fails his trial, but then it's because like it's all rain and he's never played in the rain before. Very, very unrealistic. But I think it could be realistic, especially because he's from Mexico. You know, he migrated to America from border control, but like he wasn't allowed to, but they escaped somehow. And his dad dies in it, so it does, which is very, very sad in it as well, even though he hated his dad. And because like of he kept on shouting at him to steal his money to get there. He made this guy raw as an all like here about having asthma, and then he failed his first ever match because then he got out of it because asthma, he didn't use his asthma inhaler so he could play, because it was stamped on by one of his teammates that he hates. The scout that it was is Glenn Foy. So what is that to the scout? In Goal 2, he asks him to leave and gets him like a new full-time agent who can be both around in Madrid, because he moves to Real Madrid in that movie. But he plays for Newcastle in this year. He comes on as a sub to follow him later on up. He plays amazing for the reserves after he gets explained by Gavin Harris and on all these different occasions. But anyway, like I said, he came on some perform, he didn't pass the ball, which he never does, but he got a penalty, Gavin Harris put it away. Then he started for Liverpool, they went 1-0 up, and then they went 2-1 down, and then he had to score for a kick to win it. In Goal 2, he moves to Real Madrid and all, he gets sent off after his first start after being a super sub smashing machine. Gavin Harris is also for Madrid, but he plays pure shite up until the semi-finals of the Champions League, where he gets a goal along with Munoz. Munoz gets injured after like playing kicking up with Gavin Harris at his house because Gavin has like no place to live because he was kicked out of his house for some reason, and he goes off with this other girl Munoz and Rod leaves him out, so that happens also. I don't mind your haircut, I know we down with him there, no, I was a brilliant, thank you so much, Clippers, Mr. Ban. Oh well. This video is going on long, it's gotta be one of the longest movie reviews ever made by Delirio 1526. Bummy. Oh yeah, appreciate the love, and Poppy and Corral is from Sweden here, man. You see how I can just keep my voice there and go, I don't even move my voice. Like, with most of it, I have to go like, something like that there. Why did I just do that? Did I just waste 30 seconds of time? Oh, well, like, what I'm saying, I got there to World Cup, not final. We got into the final Champions League and they were playing Arsenal. Arsenal were 2-0 up with two penalties and then they have to come back and win. Gavin Harris does a beautifully lob ball from Munoz and then boom, smashes it, Gavin Harris. And Munoz then gives a lovely left footer. And David Beckham in 2005, when he moved to Real Madrid, smashes a free kick with the right foot. They win 3-2. In the Champions League. Now we're going to go free. We're at World Cup stage and Charlie Braithwaite and Liam are in this year now. Charlie dies later on in the movie. But Charlie gets a movie part and Gavin isn't in this one either. But your man's in it. Charlie gets a movie, like a movie kind of thing. He gets a part in a movie and whenever they're coming home from the movie after Charlie meets his girl in the stream, Sophia Marie or someone like that there. True it does. A funny bit of it was Sophia was going to stick a knife in them for the movie, obviously fake. And then Liam's phone rang and said, Charlie, when the energy bro? And then they all go mad because the director also had to cut it after the phone because he couldn't obviously put that in the movie. Absolutely brilliant. And maybe the editor is just freaking like everything, man. I guarantee if you ever watch a movie, any movie in the whole world, there will be at least one scene in it where it has all been edited. Every single bit. And I guarantee what bit it is. If it's James Bond, it'll be the car chase bit. Because when I'm in Skyfall, the first... Why am I going on Skyfall? My God. But I'm just going to do this very quickly. On the chain bit, like when we were going on the like riff and all, that there, that had to be edited. Like, come on, man. There's no way. Like, the coupling off the car, like the smashing through, God, that had to be edited. They had to have edited it somehow, the way it could, like, go off, and then you just, I'm sorry, but they're not going to get a man to jump off that there and into that there, far too risky. Even if you do use a stunt man, it's too risky, you wouldn't do it, nobody would. Unless you're fucking, you want to die. Because it would be too risky, so it would. Especially if you have someone look like Daniel Craig and do it. But anyway, he's the best bomber. Back to goal. Like I'm saying, when that happens, when we're back from the final, they have a car crash, Munoz out of the World Cup from playing in Mexico, but Charlie and Liam are in the middle squad, and like, they play on through, and then Charlie dies after getting knocked out. Oh, God, it hurts and all. And he gets off, and then he dies, and then they lose to Portugal on the penalty shootout, because they lose real-life matches, so they do, and Liam rolls up the rest in pretty sure after he misses his penalty for Charlie. So they do. Liam also meets his long lost baby, who is his ex's, and they get married as well. At the end of it, Munoz is the best man, but it would have been Charlie if he didn't die. Very sad movie that there. Sometimes makes me cry. Sometimes, no? Oh, okay. For the first time I watched that, maybe. Now I'm just going to show you the discs for it, so if you already buy it, I didn't show you for the other movies because I'm not too sure. I know you can get them in DVD, but I don't have them in DVD. I don't even have Skyfall on DVD. So I just have my, like, planner. I recommend you get the double pack. They go and go to there, okay? If you open up the go there, and then you just flip that over for go to. Okay? Cool, Becker. Let me see who plays Gavin Harris. Anna Friel plays, Alessandra Navoya plays Gavin Harris, and Anna Friel plays, you man. JJ Field is Liam, and Leo Gregory is Charlie. Okay? So that's the end of this movie review, guys. It's coming up to like 9 minutes, 30 seconds. We'll do a minute outro. The longest movie review by far, I think, even on YouTube. I think I'm the only person who does movie reviews on YouTube. Leave that away for a bit. Guys, follow me on Twitter at DylanHamilton26. Add me as a fan on Facebook at Dylan Hamilton. Please, leave a like and subscribe for more. Is that you from me? Thank you.
say the same things twice. I'm awkward when I speak. Ain't got the perfect smile. Don't turn heads on my street. Try to be a superstar like everybody else. But being myself is something I do well. Whatever you do.
This has been Delineo 1426 presenting. Move review number 6. Cool! 1, 2, and 3.
Ain't got the X factor, I'm not what they expect.